G'day Mike, so today I'm going to tell you how to get rid of those bloody resort fees that they got here in Las Vegas. People say it can't be done, people say it's impossible, but I've searched far and wide, high and low, in and out, walk about, wherever. I've looked everywhere and I have found one and only one way to get rid of the bloody resort fees. It is possible in one way, and see, when you look around online you may hear people give you suggestions for how you can get rid of those resort fees. Some people might say, well, you call down to the front desk and you say, hey, I'm a good customer, would you mind giving me a break on those resort fees? Well, I can tell you right now that basically never happens, impossible. If it happens, it's a fluke. I've tried it several times. For instance, during Corona, they don't give you maid service or housekeeping during your stay. The more politically correct term, housekeeping. They don't give you housekeeping, so I thought, oh wait, I was staying at the Paris right there, and I said, oh, I'm gonna call down. I'm gonna say, hey, there's no maid service, would you mind giving me a break on those resort fees? And they basically said, bugger off, you tosser. They said no, no question about it. Right off the bat, bugger off, you tosser. There was another time we were staying at Rio, can't see from here. The only reason we went there is because they have a big pool, and the pool was closed for some reason at that place. And so eventually I got hold of the GM of the hotel, amazingly. And I said, hey, can you give us a break on the resort fees? You know, that's the reason we came here. And he was like, no, the resort fee doesn't include the pool. Can you believe that? And I said, well, if you look on the internet there, it says your resort fee includes use of the pool, which is said right on the website. And he said, well, still, I'm not gonna give it to you off. Okay. So basically impossible if you ask for it to be done. One exception to this, we stayed at SLS Sahara back when it was SLS, and the pool was closed for a private event during our stay. Crazy, private. You got a hotel with 3,000 people, you close the pool for a private event, and they offered to waive the resort fee without even asking. That was one time, that's an exception, that never happens. So it's another way people suggest you might get the resort fee off. Some people say you can gamble a lot. Maybe, but that's basically luck at that point. They may give you a discount, they may not. Total luck. And incidentally, I know a bloke who gambles a lot over at Cosmo over there, right over my shoulder, and he was offered a comp room. And when he showed up, they were like, okay, your three-night stay is gonna be $150. And he said, I thought this was comped. And they said, it is comped, but you still gotta pay that bloody resort fee. So, if you gamble a lot, maybe they'll give you it, maybe not, but you're basically playing the luck game for getting that off. Now, the one surefire way to get the resort fee off, from everywhere I've looked, is this way right here, Caesars Diamond level or above. Caesars Diamond level or above gives you a waived resort fee. And it's not like an if, ands, or but, so you have to ask the manager to waive it for you. It is waived. Now you might be wondering, how do I get Caesars Diamond? that can be, it used to be tough, but for Corona, they have some promos now, so it's not so bad. So to get Diamond or above, you need 15,000 tier credits, which has now been reduced to 12,000 tier credits because of Corona. So that makes it a little easier. And you get one tier credit for every dollar spent. Okay, so now you're thinking, well, $12,000, that's a lot of bloody money. I agree, that's not an easy way to get the resort fee. However, because of Corona, they have a promo where you get 5 tier credits for every dollar you spend on direct booking reservations. Okay, so now that's not too bad. Think about it. If you have, say, let's say you stay in a $200 a night room for 3 nights, and you do that 3 times in a year, you're already almost there to Diamond level. Just with that 3-night stay, 3 times a year, you're almost to Diamond level because of the promo. And then you add a couple of, you eat at the restaurant a couple of times, you go to the bar a couple of times, and boom, there you got it. You got your $2,500, $3,000 spend to get Diamond level. And $3,000, that's not quite as impossible as it is $12,000, what it used to be. And so that's why I think it's eminently attainable to go Caesars Diamond to get the promos. And you know, honestly, I don't have affinity to any hotel here in Las Vegas specifically, but Caesars does seem to have the absolute best benefits for the players card. And that's why I say MGM or whatever, wherever you want to go, they're all good. They're all great. They're all great hotels. But Caesars, honestly, they give you the best with their, whatever this is called, Caesars Rewards, Total Rewards, I don't know. They do seem to have the best promos, and that is the way to get rid of the bloody resort fees here in Las Vegas. The only way I found, I did notice that the Stratosphere Players Club also waives resort fees for a certain level of their Players Club, but they don't have the promos that Caesars has. So Caesars is the way to do it. Over there at MGM, at Bellagio, M Life, even if you're the very top level, they still won't raise those, they still won't waive those bloody resort fees. So that's the way to do it. Caesars Diamond, Las Vegas, you gotta get in on that while the Corona promo is running. All you need to spend is like between $2,000 and $3,000, and boom, you got waived resort fees for a year, and then it's a rolling thing, so you can keep that going for a while. Especially with the no resort fees, you can stay here more often. It's great. There you go. Caesars Diamond, the only way to get your resort fees waived here in Las Vegas, mates. Crikey, come on down. It's great.